My name is Nikki and I'm 8 years old. And the reason why I'm here is to learn about Buddhism and all that stuff. And many people in my family learn Spanish, and that's why I want to learn Spanish, so I can talk to them in Spanish too. My mom is Buddhism, so I'm sure she learned. She said that she learned her Spanish since that she was a kid, and I wanted to learn Spanish too, so I could be just like my mom.
My name is Amador, and I'm 10 years old, and I'm here because I want to be in the Alianza, and we're here to learn about the borders and how to stop them.
Hi, my name is Heather Kalinski, and I'm with the Carpe Diem Education Group, and we're here today because we're actually part of this alternative educational program that goes around the Southwest, and we volunteer and learn with various people in their communities that are doing service work or something special that's noteworthy and that we can learn from. And so we came here today to learn more about the border issues and also how that affects Mexican Americans, mm-hmm. but also how that affects Indigenous Americans and just people around the border, even if they're not directly affected, how it affects them in terms of just the communities and like how it divides communities. So we're very interested in learning about the people here.
So you say your last name?
Oh. I'm Frankie Pineda. I'm 12 years old. What else?
What did you learn? What did you like?
Oh, I like when they started dancing. I don't know her name, but the lady, she started telling that story. Gave me goosebumps. I liked it. I liked a lot of stuff that they did. A lot of the information that they gave, I learned a lot.
Hi, my name is Jacqueline Mian, and I'm 9 years old. And today, I learned that, like,
hey, what's up?
when the guy said the poems and when they started dancing and then I learned that
ball's playing in the back, so I just like the dancing and all that stuff that they did.
I'm with Unidos, and we're just really happy that there's a place here. You know, it's a teaching, and we're about autonomous education, so it's just real dope that we could still have this in our communities and have elders come out and like teach the youth about, like, just pass down the stories, because like it's not in our schools anymore, and it's of course not in our textbooks. So it's dope that elders come out and they're gonna give us like that oral history and just pass it down to us. So. Like, I'm just happy that it happened. I'm hoping that it, like, keeps happening, and I want, like, we need those plans to do teachers with youth and like just have youth teach other youth. So I'm like, out of this, I hope that happens, and just I'm really happy that it did, you know, go down. So yeah, thank you for helping.
What I like coming from this is because you get to spray paint a lot, and I like to spray paint, and I like this because you get to do a lot of activities. So, and I have a lot of friends here that play with me a lot. But even with that they're a little bossy, I still like them. Even at school, that's what happens too. But I like doing this because it's fun and you get your heart moving. So they like, and it's cool when people dance with you or play with you and stuff like that.
And my name is Jesus Valenzuela from Guadalupe, from the Pascuayaki tribe, and I came here to the youth council. They talked about borders, like the problems between the races, and it was just, you know, I learned a lot, just, you know, how to protect myself as far as like my rights and how to go about that and work. I can actually like call someone for help if, you know, if I return into trouble. And I learned a lot about other cultures too, everybody's, you know, culture.
And this one's too.
It was just amazing just to experience all that, pretty much.